tell you how Florida Atlantic strength conditioning is better than Texas and why that's probably resulted in a great Florida Atlantic team and a bad Texas team. And all that's coming up after the bumper.
What do you mean you don't subscribe to my son's YouTube channel?
Mama, no!
Just snap the damn ball, RJ.
What's up, kinfolk? It's RJ Young. I am not on a step mill. Consider hitting the like and subscribe button because I upload a video every single day. It's always OU-related, college football-related, sports-related. We have a good time. So this story was tipped to me by Don King, who's a great friend of the channel, about how DeAndre McNeil and Marcel Southall were Texas Longhorns, a former four-star receiver and a former three-star defensive tackle, who signed with Charlie Strong's 2015 class. Each one of them transferred following Texas's bad 5-7 2016 season. Both of them ended up at Florida Atlantic, where they quickly found out how out of shape they were. FAU strength and conditioning coach Wilson Love showed none when he put them through their paces. Each one of them told FAU's Al All Access that FAU's fourth quarter conditioning was far superior to Texas's fourth quarter conditioning. Southall put it this way: I was shocked. It was a whole different level than Texas. It got me back in shape, pushing me to a different level that I haven't been pushed before. McNeil echoed it, saying, quote, "Oh yes, by far, the fourth quarter program is no joke. I can definitely say that." Southall has reportedly shed 20 pounds since going to Florida Atlantic, which is bonkers, because why is FAU strength and conditioning program better than Texas strength and conditioning program? We all know Texas prints money hand over fist. We all know Texas is a blue blood program, but now we're getting to understand why Texas football has been trash. It's because they don't really know what they're doing as far as conditioning the kids. Because if you can go from a program that's in the Big 12 that should be competing for national championships and isn't, to Conference USA, to play with a bunch of guys that came from Last Chance U under a coach that nobody wanted, and all of a sudden you can go and win games, win 11 games, and be a threat to be the Group of Five representative in the New Year's Six. My goodness, Texas, what are y'all doing? Well, we know what Florida Atlantic's doing. Florida Atlantic is coming to Oklahoma on a 10-game winning streak, and they have been gearing up for Oklahoma since their season ended. And it's not like they're coming in there expecting to mollywop the Sooners. They're coming in with tremendous respect. Lane Kiffin told the Tulsa World, "It's always hard to follow a legendary coach like he had to do. It helps to have a great quarterback, too. It's kind of the story of all of us. When you have a really great quarterback, you are a lot better coach. He did a great job in a hard spot to fill," which is great praise from a guy who's coached from pretty good quarterbacks. And he's hoping to bring two with him to Norman when FAU comes to town, in DeAndre Johnson and Chris Robinson. You might remember Robinson was recruited to Oklahoma, signed when Oklahoma got kicked off of Oklahoma. And Kiffin knows he's going to have to do a great job calling the game around any one of his quarterbacks. He also has championship pedigree to fall back on, having been the offensive coordinator for very good Alabama teams. And while Kiffin alone adds a lot of star power to this Florida Atlantic team, having coached at Alabama, USC, the Raiders, Tennessee, and while it's also very interesting that Florida Atlantic has a quarterback competition going on between three guys, two of which I mentioned, the other being Rafe Peavy, the most compelling storyline for me is his offensive coordinator, 25-year-old Charlie Weiss Jr., who apparently has like a photographic memory. And Andy Staples did a great feature on Charlie Weiss Jr. describing how Weiss got the job. Kiffin handed Weiss his credit card and his driver's license, told him he could hold them for 3 minutes, and then took them back and asked him two questions. One was, "What street do I live on?" And the other was, "What's the expiration date on my credit card?" Weiss got them both correct. And that's the kind of offensive coordinator he has, a guy that can remember what he's done, what other folks have done on the fly. And it's nice to have somebody with that kind of recall in a sport that is so dependent on patterns and principles that it's sometimes ridiculous how math-oriented football is. And if you got a guy that can recall what a defensive coordinator has done on a given down and distance, that's a really awesome weapon to have, especially if you're playing against Mike Stoops' defense. And while Charlie Weiss Jr. just turned 25 in April, it ain't like he just kind of lucked in this position. He worked with Kiffin at Alabama, but before that, when his dad was hired to run the offense for Will Muschamp at Florida, Charlie Weiss Jr. took a job on the bottom of the pile. Because you know the guys who assist the assistants, the analysts, the quality control guys? Charlie Weiss Jr. was their assistant. And along the way, throughout his come up from Florida to Kansas to Alabama, he's got to listen to and work with some of the better minds on the offensive side of the ball, including not just his dad, who won a Super Bowl as an offensive coordinator, but Art Briles' son, Kendall Briles, and Steve Sarkisian, as well as Kiffin. Now, it's still an open question as to who's going to call the plays for FAU, whether it be Kiffin or Weiss Jr., because Lane Kiffin is the kind of head coach that Lincoln Riley is, and that I'm sure that he would like to call his own plays. But he did give an answer about how he plans to collaborate with Charlie Weiss Jr., so that'll be interesting to watch, especially as this Florida Atlantic team has never really really played a team on the level of Oklahoma since Kiffin has been there. And they're kind of the it team in the group of five. Now that Scott Frost left UCF to go to Nebraska, good luck to you, Josh Heupel. But I'm really excited to see Kiffin and Weiss Jr. versus Riley, and also to see what kind of offense Lane Kiffin puts in front of Mike Stoops, and see if Mike Stoops can think about Lane Kiffin as a guy still wearing a Crimson Tide visor and rekindle that same magic he had in 2014 to beat Alabama when Lane Kiffin was the offensive coordinator. And while Kiffin isn't talking noise, he's being very humble and very gracious in what he says about Oklahoma, FAU star running back Devin Singletary ain't having it. Singletary, who was a third team All-American last year at running back, thinks that FAU is coming to Norman to storm the gates. Because when he was asked to describe his football team, he said, quote, savages. That's the best way to put it. Savages. He followed up saying, obviously Oklahoma is always tough. Just watching football and seeing Oklahoma, they always have some dudes and they always have a good team. We know we will have our hands full. Yeah, you will. And bring your savages so y'all can hold this L. Right, that's it for me. Deuces.